And I looked at those, and I used to feel a bit slighted that I hadn't been able to sit and nick ideas off of the Beatles and the Beach Boys and all the other people that nicked off ideas and backwards and forwards, you know, shamelessly, but still had their own thing.
Right.
And the Beatles is really
ones of one another.
Yeah, when you look at the background to a lot of the Beatles songs, and the Beatles were wonderful, they're nicking stuff from these black artists.
And doing riffs.
They're nicking riffs. Riffs, they're nicking all sorts, yeah.
And doing actually some of it really badly. And very obviously, you know, Pet Sounds and the fact that really what they were trying to do at the beginning of the Beatles was actually their own version of Motown. But actually the Beatles had no understanding of R&B whatsoever. That's what makes them stand out so differently from, that's what makes them so different to the Stones. And that's what's interesting. I can't really get anything out of the early Beatles stuff other than, it gives you that elation that Motown records do to a degree, but I need that R&B that Motown provided, you know. In reality, I love the later Beatles stuff because I think what they were doing in terms of, you know, in terms of the imagination and the fact that they were using drugs and the fact that people hadn't mixed different cultures. The way they mixed cultures towards the end was wonderful. The beginning, it doesn't really have that magic for me.